this time, the target was Roosevelt High School, another apparent crime of opportunity where the thieves knew what to look for and where.
This is the trailer they broke into, one of several at Roosevelt owned by DeVries Electric out of Pella. They've been busy working on the high school's renovation this summer.
The lock was gone. So it's inside job, you know, somebody knew us, who knows.
This copper insulated wire is the exact same as what the thieves took. Workers tell me that if this spool was full, it would weigh about 250 pounds, so the thieves probably took off with the equivalent of about 3 spoolfuls of this copper wire.
A Des Moines scrapyard quoted insulated copper wire for $1.35 a pound, so the 800 pounds stolen at Roosevelt is worth over $1,000.
We don't feel like there's a lot of value in copper, but when you steal enough of it, evidently there is enough. So these guys feel it's worth the risk.
This is just the latest in a long string of copper thefts this year. The strangest by far was when thieves stripped copper wire out of these Des Moines cell phone towers back in June. It's a popular crime because copper is hard to trace and easy to unload. Only a fraction of the cases have been solved.
Every now and then we get lucky and we'll get a few arrests, but this summer they've been working overtime.
Baker Electric out of Des Moines also reported to police today the theft of over $1,400 worth of copper wire out of a downtown loft project. The superintendent at Baker told me that it's not unusual to have this kind of theft happen, especially since the economy's gone bad and copper prices have gone through the roof. Back to you.